Hello, you sexy beasts! Today I'm going to talk about the difference between an irritation and an allergic reaction. Both produce a lot of redness, swelling, pain, and unhappiness, so they can seem like they're the same thing, but they're actually really different. Irritation is more common and is often associated with using a substance too frequently or at high levels of concentration, like when your kids watch Frozen, over and over and over again. This reminds me of my skincare strategy for most of my 20s. I'd use a clay mask, and if I saw a little improvement, you can bet your bottom I'd be going overboard with it, using it 5 nights a week, until my skin was totally red and irritated. Too much washing, over-exfoliating with scrubs or chemicals, using too many drying ingredients like isopropyl or SD alcohol, and even overdoing aromatherapy, all of these can strip the lipids from your skin, damaging the skin barrier and causing irritation. Yeah, stop overdoing it. Or it's possible you could just be more sensitive than others. A concentration of 5% might be okay for your bestie, but not for you. The result of irritation is skin that is red, flaky, and uncomfortable. An allergy is the body's immune system reacting to a specific substance. In some cases, an allergy could be potentially fatal. The immune system identifies the substance as foreign and reacts by sending out killer T cells to fight off the offending substance. You might already recognize some common allergens: peanuts, nickel, fragrances, PPD, some preservatives. A good friend of mine just patch tested positive for an allergy to nickel. She couldn't believe it because she had worn a nickel necklace many times before. But apparently, that is one of the signs of an allergic response. You can use a product or an ingredient repeatedly, and the allergic reaction only happens when your immune system becomes sensitized. After that, even a tiny exposure can provoke a huge response. It can take your body some time to build up an immune response, so if you suspect you're having an allergic reaction, it may be a product you used before without any trouble. So how can I tell if it's an allergy or irritation? Here are some differences. Allergic reactions are usually more severe and can happen after tiny amounts of exposure. On the other hand, irritations vary with the amount of exposure. Irritation reactions often take place at the site where the ingredient contacted the skin, but allergic responses can happen anywhere on the body. Allergic reactions are personal. You may be allergic to peanuts, but the person next to you might be just fine. Irritants are usually universal. An irritant for one is generally an irritant for all, though not everyone's skin barrier is the same, so even with irritants, the scale of the reaction may differ from person to person. Why is this beneficial to know? Because in either case, you need to modify your behavior. If it's an irritation, you can just reduce the strength or frequency of whatever's causing it. But if it's an allergen, you need to avoid the ingredient altogether. Time to start reading those labels. Oh wait, you find cosmetic labels confusing? Only if there was a YouTube channel that could help. Subscribe to Miss Beautiful so you can check out my next video.